Ladies and gentlemen, this RedGamersHead.com video, we're going to be taking a look at Splinter Cell Blacklist for the PC. Now, I've got it paused at the moment because we're right into the action. This is literally the very start of the game, so we're not going to be having any spoilers. We're going to be taking a look at it and just how it plays and so on PC. Of course, this is the PC version. I'm going to be taking a look at the video options before we go any further. I've got this on custom at 1080p. Of course, I'm going to be 16:9, so nothing particularly complicated there. However, it has got a relatively decent advanced options. Now, we're going to talk about this quite in depth for just for a moment, because I've noticed a couple of issues on my graphics card, which is GeForce. Now, my card plays everything absolutely fine until you start putting anything that's not FXAA. I have a feeling it's a bug, because the performance is absolutely huge, so I'm guessing it's a driver issue rather than anything else, because the performance otherwise is over 60 frames per second. And if I enable a different level of anti-aliasing, for example, that, I notice huge dips, and I don't exactly know what that's about. So I'm just going to be leaving FXAA, and I'm going to be doing some further playing around tomorrow. But for now, it does look absolutely gorgeous regardless. So regardless, tessellation is on. Now, I just want to talk about one last little thing. If you are one of those people who has a DX9 card, you're not going to have advanced shadow quality. Advanced texture quality will be there, but you're not going to have advanced shadows. Anyway, hopefully we've gone through that and you understand it. So now I'm going to jump right into the game. As I said, I'm going to be using keyboard and mouse. So, it does look fairly nice. It's using, of course, the Unreal Engine, which isn't particularly surprising or anything like that. Pros, we're not even packing sirens. Drainage just will give us some cover. Right. So, it does look fairly nice. It's not exactly crisis-free, but the lens flaring, water quality... Wow, okay. Things are kind of exploding around me. Fire. Sounded like Katushas. Okay, so we can press C to crouch. That's good to know. Probably not a good idea to get spotted. No, I'm going to say those guys are not friendly. Fire effects. Fire is always a bit dicey in games. And for me, I find it's probably one of the most immersion-breaking aspects of it. But the water itself and the particles of the water do look quite pretty, at least in my personal opinion. So we're going to just be going lights on your gear flare up when you're in shadow. Makes sense. Vic, don't move. Well, this escalated quickly. As I said, I'm starting basically the very start, because this is a very story-orientated game. And so I imagine most of you guys don't want anything particular spoiled later on. Maybe I'm wrong. Okay, maybe I have to... Okay, press E to boost. Hello. Oh, there we go. Apparently I had to be in exactly the right spot, but whatever. Fancy helping me up there, bro? No. Okay, just good to know these things. Copy. Cue to enter cover mode. Space to next cover. Okay, this is very, 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 very much like Conviction. Yeah. Get the camera going. Bravo Company just bagged a corporal. I have to admit, I was quite a big fan of Let's get that camera going. Hold tab. Press B. Lethal, baby. Yeah. Okay, ready. Ow. He's bleeding out, but he's not going anywhere if they're blocking Carlo. I'll stabilize him. You take out the jam. Okay, so next cover. So controls are very similar to, let's say, Splinter Cell Conviction. And to be honest with you, excuse me, guys, it works really well. I'm actually quite a big fan of Splinter Cell Conviction, as I've made fairly vocals. So we're just going to have a quick look. I'm just going to stand here like a twit in the middle of a war zone because I think that's a sensible thing to do. We're going to have a look around. Despite the fact that, yes, the fire looks a bit dicey, or as us English would say, a bit dodgy in occasion, textures overall do look very sharp. I am getting 60 frames per second solid, even despite recording, which is quite interesting. The game actually supports it really well. I'm going to be doing further graphics comparisons, but they're not going to be in this video, so you guys can see what it looks like if you've got a poorer machine over the next couple of days, if you're just not that sure about how it is all going to run and all. But for me, if you've got a fairly decent graphics card, like a fairly modern NVIDIA card, for example, you'll be absolutely fine. I imagine it's the same for AMD as well. Stay out the light. That sounds a very good plan to me, considering they all have weapons. So, cover works extremely well, I must confess. I actually love this because it gives you a lot of control. Yeah, I definitely don't want to get even involved with that. They have a hell of a lot of weapons, and it would not go... Oh, shit. Oh, crap. Okay, well, at least we know how that works. Oh, dear. Well, apparently you die pretty quickly. At least we know that. That's what you get for trying to be a smartass. Execute ready. I'm not actually sure how you execute anyone, but whatever. Alright, let's try and do that and not suck this time. That'd probably be very good. Alright, I should probably warn you guys, I'm not exactly the best at stealth games, but there you have it. I'm just going to give you guys a quick rundown of a few other bits and bobs that's going to be happening on the channel. Obviously, I will be doing a lot of tech stuff over the next couple of days as well. This is just a small mental break for me. I might be putting out another tech video today. I'm not exactly sure what's going to happen. Actually, for those of us who are uninitiated with the controls, i.e., you know, me, let's have a quick look at what they've got everything bound to. So you can indeed decide to enable aim assist. Probably should have checked this out earlier. You can indeed enable look inversion as well, should you so desire. Strafe, nothing particularly complicated there. Crouch, cover. Caps lock allows you to walk. Aim, of course. Hang, mark. Oh, mark is alt. And execute is control. And you've got various vision modes as well. So we'll probably see a lot of that later on. Okay, so we can actually get a semblance of where these guys are, which is a good thing. There is a hell of a lot of these dudes, isn't there? Alright, anyway, let's move to the next cover. Carefully, we shall endeavor to move forward. I'm going to mark that guy, I think. Okay, let's be very careful about this. Thank you. Not exactly super sneaky, but, you know, whatever. Oh, God. Okay. All right, cool. And he's dead as well. Not too bad. Wasn't exactly the smoothest thing I've ever done in my life, but hey, whatever. Fear me. Apparently I'm gonna go militaristic style. I feel like I'm more playing Gears of War at this point, but whatever. You have an equipped unscience weapon. I do indeed have an equipped unscience weapon. I thought that was kind of the idea. Now, if I actually had a silenced weapon, I could do something pretty cool here. I could actually, no doubt, take these lights out, but obviously that's not the case. Son. Shit.
All right, sit tight, kid. I'm gonna get you some help.
Friendly. You know how to disable that thing?
I'm working on it. How's the kid?
Don't ask.
Charlie, we're in.
All right, all right. All you need to do is disable the voltage oscillator and disrupt the competing signal.
Just hold still. No talking, okay?
Charlie, how about an on-off switch?
Do you see a blue button?
Yeah.
Hit it.
What are you saying? What are you telling me, buddy? What are you telling me? Jeez.
Jammer's offline, Vic.
You can't stop the blacklist.
Grenade!
Ow. Okay. So we're in a new area now. Ooh, shiny. So far it controls fairly well, despite the fact that I suck at it.
A massive U.S. military installation on the island of Guam.
The deadliest strike on a U.S. base since Pearl Harbor. A group calling themselves the...
I am going to skip long cutscenes, just so you guys are aware, because I don't want to spoil too much for you guys. I just want to mostly focus on showing you guys the gameplay rather than anything else. So anything that's too lengthy, I'll just simply slice out.
Charlie's got some new gear he's working.
Sam, Grim.
Listen, Sam.
Plan upgrades. Grim, let's go with... Ew, okay, let's actually look at this. Okay, so I've got 70,000. Cockpit, sophisticated sensors, track assets. That sounds pretty cool. Alright, let's go for that. Continue. That used a little bit of my money. Alright. Okay, cool. It's loading the fact that I've got an upgraded shiny stuff. I do like upgraded shiny things. They do always please me. Okay. Forward flight deck. Let's have a little look at that, shall we?
Setup almost complete, Charlie.
Yeah, hang on. Ow! Hey! Hey, Sam. We're pretty much good to go here. Just gotta overclock a couple.
Customized gear. Campaign. Okay. Loadout A. Gadgets. I'm just gonna show you guys this stuff. Sticky EMP. I'm just going to go through it so you guys can have a look. I'm not going to bother to select too much stuff, but I just want to show you guys the various menus and so on, and then you can play around with it when you've got more time. I obviously don't really have much time because I'm trying to show as much stuff as possible for you. You know, of course, buy different pistols, different weapons in black markets, but unfortunately I can't do that yet. You can actually get a crossbow. That's pretty cool. Going to want to check that out now. All right. Also got different ops. Let's go torso. So you can get like Kevlar weave to reduce incoming damage and shiny bits like that. So.
What are you working on besides annoying Grim?
Anything I can.
Launch mission. Solo. Alright, let's have a quick look at this. Loadout A. Have a quick look at a couple of missions just to get an idea of what it's about. So once again, this is mostly just to show you guys what the controls are like, what the story's like, get an idea of, you know, the graphical upgrades from previous games, the gameplay, that type of thing.
Not until there's a break in the fighting. You'll have to hold out until then. Those barricades look like the best defensive position nearby.
I'll be that.
Okay, so survive 20 waves and extract.
5 seconds until contact.
Right climb. Let's climb again. No, you don't. Don't be silly. I don't have a clue if any of this is going to work, but it usually does quite well in other Splinter Cell games. So I figure if I stay all the way up here, how can they shoot me? This is just a pure theory on my part. It doesn't mean it's going to actually help. Although, to be fair, I do need to actually take some of them out. There's a laptop here. I wonder what this does.
Anything over there? Grim, I've hacked into this laptop. You've got access.
I'll tell Charlie.
Where the hell are these noobs? That's what I want to know. So, as I said, if anything takes too long, I will cut it out. Because this isn't the Let's Play, this is just to give you an idea of what some of the modes are like. Ah. Okay, let's be a bit cautious when we're dropping down. Don't want to suddenly get like 15 trillion enemies on me. That would be bad. You know what? I've got a good amount of ammo. It's actually quite nice to have these different modes in. It gives you a bit of variety, you know what I'm saying? A little bit of a variety. And who doesn't like a little bit of variety? So you guys can get an idea of the murderiness.
They're getting ready for another run at you. Hostile contact in 5 seconds.
Not too sure where they're going to be coming from, but regardless, what we got here? Might as well. So it looks like they're over that side. Catch. Should be one more guy. Oh, hi. Oh, dear. You know what? I'm just going to let myself die so we can actually move on to something a bit different. You guys... Okay, he spazzed out a little bit there. There's a bit of an interesting... Oh, okay. Apparently not. Okay. Well, can we abort mission? Okay, let's just abort the mission. Kind of thought if I died it would abort the mission, apparently not. Anyway, so you get one idea of one type of a game, so you can be happy to murder like trillions of people, and obviously you do get money for that as well, so that's one way to upgrade your shit, as they would say.
think Charlie's got some new gear he's working on.
Okay, so it's infirmary. Let's see.
Hey, Sam. Almost forgot. Your op stat. New and improved. Sort of like your S.
Cool. Alright. So I move the slider until the text appears in the bottom, just visible. For me, it's about there. I don't know about your screen, but whatever. Blacklist single player. Okay, so let's check this out. Solo, start briefing, leaderboards, stop. Okay. I'm just going to skip this stuff because, as I said, I don't want to bore you guys. I just want to, this is very, very different state of affairs, a lot more open world than previous affairs. I don't have a particular problem with it, per se. Alright, let's just exit and launch. I kind of like it. It feels kind of a bit different, but nice nevertheless. Graphically, I must say, it's quite pretty. There are a couple of issues here and there, the old dicey physics here and there. Fire, of course, is still a bit dicey in games. Okay.
Briggs, you have a visual on the safe house.
I just got here. It doesn't look good.
Textures aren't too bad, even up close. I mean, they're not exactly amazing, but they're certainly not too bad. They're much better, of course, than what you'd see on a console. But, okay.
I'm entering the plaza. Militia's blocking the front door access.
Sam, do you need to change position? Meet you on the ground?
Get eyes from the southwest corner of the plaza.
Copy. Moving now.
I'm assuming I can't just walk through here. Contact.
Let me know if you get through.
No.
Copy.
One cannot simply walk through that way. One would probably get shot to shit. So let us make a slight detour. It's actually quite detailed, actually, the various environments. Okay. Well, that escalated quickly. I thought that dude was out here.
Still moving, Sam. I'm seeing a lot of militia down there. Might get loud.
We'll keep it quiet as long as we can. Moving to the side entrance.
Let's face it. We're not going to be going non-lethal, are we? Alright, what we got? Night vision goggles, sticky camera. Sticky noisemaker. They're very sticky, apparently. Stun gun. Well, I guess stun gun would be the non-lethal approach, but I'll prefer to shoot them in the face repeatedly. Although it would be kind of fun, I suppose, to check out what the stun gun does do. No doubt we'll try that out. Then. Okay, you know what? This guy's going to have to get stun gunned, I think. Take downs to fill up your weapon gauge. Okay. If we could ask him, you would be dead. Press E for hand. Ooh, shit, son. Execute ready. Your gauge is now full. Execute ability ready. Okay. Mark the targets. Cool. Not too shabby. Oh, sorry, so you don't actually have to open up the wheel, by the way. You can just press B to quickly switch. Which is good. Which is very good. This guy is a funny guy. Let's try out the noisemaker. Well, sort of worked. It wasn't exactly what I was hoping for, but whatever. That guy's a soldier. He's just like soldiering the bullets in his back and pretty much every other location as well. He now has several more orifices because of me. Assuming that's just where I came from, but it doesn't hurt to actually have a little look in here, I suppose. We could indeed pick up the body, but I'm not going to because, you know, screw them. I'm not actually sure what that does, but that looks bad. Oh, that's actually how you throw. I'm going to cancel that. Click dead drop. It literally was a flashing drive as well. You can't really get much clearer than that. Hi, bro. Well, that sucks to be you. Right. So, I am quite enjoying the game, I must confess. I think this is a case of if you've enjoyed previous Splinter Cells, you will enjoy this one. It does handle kind of weird for those of you who are uninitiated with Splinter Cell, if you're more familiar with like Metal Gear Solid, for example, simply because of the way the cover system works, but I am actually quite a fan of it. By the way, you can, of course, look under doors and stuff. I actually did kind of forget to mention that. The only problem I have with this is that it's exactly the same button to look under doors as it is to open doors. And I don't know if I've ever mentioned this in games, but it really irritates me, that kind of stuff, because it's absolutely unnecessary. And occasionally you can be like, oops, wrong, oh shit, that was an accident. Occasionally it is not too difficult to accidentally open the wrong door or whatever. Oh dear. I have to be in there, and I don't really think I'm going to be able to do it through going through here. I just have a feeling it's going to be locked. I had a feeling. Okay, what we can do... You know what? Let's just be mean and actually have a firefight for a little bit. Just because I want to kind of actually get some enemies' attention and try it out. Oh dear. Okay, they are going kind of crazy. Okay, he's in there, which kind of sucks for me, actually. Oh, okay, that hurt. Alright, that didn't go too well. Oh, balls.
Damn, you've got multiple targets ahead. One on the balcony.
Is there viable stealth approach?
Go into the room to your right. Out the window and traverse the ledge.
Nice work.
Or I could just do that. You know, that kind of works as well. I always like trying to play games in very different ways. I don't know about you guys. It's always more fun if you try and find different...
Everyone, on alert.
I need help searching.
You'll need more than a new bulb in a moment, bro. You go in there. Stealthy, no. Killing and murdery, fun, yes. So I think that just is more important. I don't know about you guys. Right. Apparently we've got loads of friends that aren't that important to do anything with, so I guess we just ignore them. And up one, and up another one it looks like, maybe. Maybe I have to kind of scroll around. There we go, through this one. That wasn't quite what I was hoping for. You're just gonna chill in the. That's not ideal. That is not ideal.
He's right there. I see. Khaliqum al-Zahrin.
There we go. I pick that up. Okay, cool. We'll switch that off as well, just to make it look more suspicious. You can't shoot them, just in case you're curious. I did try, so I'm going to get just a little bit further, and then I'm going to call this video, because I think you guys have an idea now of some of the missions and just how it works, as I said. It is possible to go into this game fairly all guns blazing, but you're not really doing it in the spirit of things. I am, obviously, just because I'm trying to go through a little bit faster. Oh, shit. Ow, ow, ow. I didn't really expect to be blown up so instantly, to be honest. The grenades have huge range on this. Gonna remember that. Gonna remember that grenades have absolutely insane range. Alright. Okay, just trying to remember what the hell the run button was as well.
Nice work securing the package.
Roger that.
Hi, Bert.
Confirmed Coben was in here, Briggs.
Right place, right.
Roger that.
I'm gonna get just a little bit further. I'm gonna get just past this little bit, and then I'm gonna call that you are being quick. Unsilenced weapon.
It's not good. Local militia took it over and fortified it.
Coben's our only shot.
Cool. I do actually have a silenced weapon. That means ninja reef kills shall be mine. Should be able to get up here quite easily, I would imagine. Okay, you can also do this for free as well. I do want to check this out. I think at least we need to look at one stun gun. I don't know about you guys. I'm not quite sure how I'm supposed to get over this, if I'm honest. Q maybe to drop one.
Can't stop them all. Change position.
Affirmative. I'm moving out.
You know what though? This guy actually thinks he's gonna live. Bless him. But not even slightly. There we go. We don't want to give him any false hope now, do we? It's always about being a bastard in these games. Yeah. Okay. Let's shimmy on over. Shimmy, shimmy, shimmy. There we go. What have we got up here?
Shortcut to the police station. It'll be on your op set.
Roger that.
I don't know what that was. Dance, noob. There we go. Give me that restock. Alright. Whee! I wasn't exactly as far as I was expecting to even go there, so cool. I'll take that. There was a little bit of a frame rate drop as it was loading into the new area, but that's not... Right there. Don't worry about it. Did you hear that? You know what? Abandon. I have some serious firepower, so I'm going to abandon that hiding spot for a moment. There we go. Enemies are pretty dumb, actually, at this level of difficulty. I would actually recommend turning it up one. I wonder if that's stupid enough to fall for that. I've got to say, bullets are extremely accurate in this gun, in this weapon, and I know that's a bit obvious to say that bullets are accurate, but there are so many games where the crosshair is just absolutely useless. So, my overall thoughts so far, and bear in mind, it's still very early into the game, and I'll probably do another video on this, actually, with graphical stuff and other bits and bobs as well. I just want to get an initial video out there. My thoughts and opinions are this. Don't play on normal difficulty like I've been doing. I've just been mostly doing that to get a bit further in. I would recommend trying to be as stealthy as possible, because on normal you can just kind of shoot your way through, especially early on. The graphics are quite nice overall. I would say that one issue I do have is the fact that the exact same button to open doors is to look under them as well. I hate stuff like that in games. You know what? I know on joypads it's a bit trickier. But I'm sure there's ways around it, even on joypad, so I don't like that. It just makes the game a bit too finicky. Overall controls, however, are nice, and it is a very good PC port. Single digits on Langley's most wanted. If you capture him, we'll arrange for pickup. And so I can't really say this is like the worst game in the world. It is certainly not the best game either, but considering that... It's so much content in here. I mean, it does feel that there's a lot of content. It feels that it's pretty solid. By the way, Ubisoft did patch the game basically at launch. So there's 1.01, I think. There is a small bug, as I said, with graphics on my system. I'm just going to barge in here, even though it's, like, you know, not really what you're supposed to do. But regardless, as I said, I did have a small issue with anti-aliasing modes on my graphics card. But that's not particularly a big deal. I think it's to do with the driver. I imagine in a couple of days' time, the video will probably release one. So I'm just going to kind of go crazy for a second, and then I'll... Oh, you can actually destructible environments. Check it. It's kind of nice. You don't need to see me. Right, let's just keep going forward. Well, I'm alive, don't worry, bro. There's a hell of a lot of bathrooms in this. Yes. Alright, anyway. I think that's a pretty good place to call this video. As I said, I would recommend having the game on a higher difficulty setting. And I would also recommend not going the gung-ho approach. But as I said, it is there just so that I think people can enjoy it. I'm pretty happy with the game. I think it's a good purchase. And so if you're a fan of Splinter Cell, you can certainly do a lot worse. Anyway, as I said, that's it for this particular video. Hopefully you've enjoyed it. I will see you soon. Take care. Bye for now.